Welcome back to a special edition of Great Day Live from Northeast Christian Church on Brownsboro Road. Jason Shreve, my co-host today.
Hello,
good
Eric.
To have you.
Yeah. Great to be here.
I'm glad to hear you say that. So we're obviously bumping up against Thanksgiving. It's tomorrow.
Yeah.
That came out of nowhere, at least it feels like. It really did. It really just kind of popped up on us very quickly. So I'm excited to be able to see some family. I think a lot of people are also. We typically think turkey dinners when it comes mm-hmm. to Thanksgiving. And a lot of us, a lot of our families, people in our family, bought the turkeys, you know, quite a while ago, but obviously not everybody has the privilege and the ability to do that. A lot of families in Kentuckiana just simply can't. That is until Northeast Christian steps in to help. So you recently had, and I want to make sure I understand this, it was a packing party.
It was a packing party, and so our goal was, after our Sunday morning services, to have all the food out there available and then invite everybody from the church to be able to go pack a box, and not just pack a box full of, you know, the sweet potatoes, two cans of corn, two cans of green beans, stuffing, desserts, all that stuff. But also to pray over it, because the families, that's a very physical need. It's a very real need, but there are so many needs. And so we really wanted to pray for those families who are going to get these. And then also pray for our partners who we disperse the boxes out through, which has been pretty fantastic. We didn't get to do all that on a Sunday morning because we had some rain, and rain and cardboard boxes don't go well together. But we were able to come back on the next Saturday morning and finished packing about 600 of the boxes up. So we had all told about 1,000 boxes that we were able to share to the folks in our community who really have that great need.
Who did that for you? Was it members of your congregation?
So we have an amazing outreach team. You mentioned Tamara a few minutes ago. We also have Leslie and Rosemarie and CJ on our staff who really did the setup for the event, got everything prepared, and then we just had so many of our folks who just showed up to do it. Young families, all kinds of people who just, like, we probably had about 200 people on that early Saturday morning, and it was amazing how quickly, about 25 minutes, we packed over 600 boxes.
What went into these boxes?
So it was all the basics of corn and green beans and the sweet potatoes and the stuffing and mashed potatoes and desserts. And then we also have a coupon for meat, which is, it's a pretty incredible thing. You can use it in any of the grocery stores. So they could either choose to get whatever meat they want or some other food item. And so it really is a whole good meal for a family. And there really is great need. One of our partners who came to pick up the boxes that we had set aside for them, Scarlet Hope, who ministered to women in the adult entertainment industry. And she had said that she had a client come into her office earlier that week and said, "We just don't have any food for Thanksgiving." And she said, "Just wait, it's coming."
Well, who else gets these meals? I know, obviously, you packed a lot, so they've got to go.
So all the way from Portland Promise Center to some friends at Emmanuel Baptist Church downtown, Greater New Beginnings Christian Church. They were able to give a lot of them. We gave 20 boxes to each of our school partners so the FRCs can distribute those. The TAP school got one for every one of the students that are there. And so really just a bunch of partners across the board who have people, who have clients that they serve, who really have that need.
So if people missed out on the opportunity to pack those boxes, are there other opportunities, other ways to get involved, other ways to help?
There's always opportunities coming up. We have our Love the Ville Christmas party coming up soon, which is one of my favorite days of the year. It's amazing because we invite a bunch of our elementary school kids from our partner schools. So we have 7 elementary partner schools, and we invite those. We have the FRCs send us names of folks who could really be blessed by it. They come in, they're going to get 8 presents. They're going to have a party around a table with a person who's just loving on them. It's so cool to see them walk in because they walk in so reserved and like, what is this weird place? Who are these weird people? And by the end, they're all just going wild because they just know that they're safe, that they're loved. And so we give a lot of giveaways, like bikes, some awesome giveaways. We have one of our worship leaders, Aaron, will come in and sing Christmas songs with them. We'll show a little bit of our movie that we made last year. But really, it is just to show these kids that they're loved. And so the presents that we give out at those are ones that we give the tags. People go out, buy them, wrap them, bring them back. And so we'll disperse all those gifts that day. So if you're looking for a way to get involved at our Brownsboro campus and our Clifton campus, we'll have a bunch of those tags available for gifts. It's over 1,600 gifts, total. So it's a lot of presents.
Well, leading into that, we'll mention that you can always keep up with Northeast Christian Church and the Love the Ville movement online, the address nacchurch.org and lovetheville.org. All right, speaking of helping people over the holidays, Great Day Live's Joanne Dixon recently met with one of the people behind Love Transformation Project to find out how we can get involved this Thanksgiving. We'll have that story for you coming up after the break.